Howdy ho, everybody! It's I, Jeremy, aka XLJ the OG, with the beautiful wifey.
Hi.
She says hello. And we are here to see Brooks and Dunn. But I gotta admit, something doesn't feel right. Hold on a second.
Okay, Cowboy Bebop.
Hell yeah! Now I'm ready to see some Roddy Kicks and some Brooks Dunn, and I think I fucked their names up, but I don't care. We're gonna have a rootin, tootin good time. Woo!
She had a gold class ring when the night was born. It was one of those, no, you're never gonna be the same. We snuck off just around midnight.
Mark. Well, we got in here okay. First act, I forget the guy's name, but he's pretty good. You remember?
LV Shane.
Obviously, I'm not a country person. You can tell totally. I look like fucking Boss Hog or something. Damn, Duke boys! No, seriously, though. First act was pretty good. Yeah, so. Up next, we got a little bit of Travis Tramp. And he's the scootin' boogie guy, right? No? Oh, I knew that.
Travis Tramp is great.
She works bar mitzvahs and weddings, so it's very impressive, young lady. All right, so we're gonna get ready for some Travis Tramp. See you in a few. Yeah.
Faces. God bless you. Live free or die is what I say, folks.
Hell yeah! Woo!
We got a bunch of music we're going to do for you tonight. I hope you do me a favor. If we do a song that you recognize, I hope that you'll help us out by singing that song back to us really loud. All right, where we can hear you up here. And I only have one rule for singing along, and that is this. If you're going to sing, sing good, and I'll try to do the same. Have fun, everybody. We're going to get high.
Even sit in a real job on your
Finished up with the Travis Tritt, and I have to say I was pretty damn impressed. I know this young lady over here liked him. She approves. I tell you what, it was the most adorable thing. I can look across while he was playing, and you had like the cutest smile on your face. You're just like, you could tell you were loving it. And that right there, folks, is worth the price of admission. I'm gonna tip my hat to you, Travis Tritt. All right, let's get some Brooks and Dunn.
Say, old man of the house, you better think of song.
We made it back to the homestead. Okay, hat's coming off. So yeah, was a pretty good show. I was impressed. I'm not a country music guy. I'll state that. the obvious there for me anyway. But yeah, it was a really good show. Travis Tritt, very good. Very, very emotional for him too. I don't know if this is like, I'm assuming this is his first time on the road in a while, maybe since the pandemic, but like, man, he just, he put on a heck of a show, like, had a good set. And then Brooks and Dunn, man, they killed it. They killed it. The best part for me was just looking over and seeing Savannah, man, she was having a blast. She was, like, and Brooks and Dunn went through their set, and they're just knocking them out of the park, man. It was a lot of positive vibes. It was good. Like, it felt just good to be there. Even if you're not a country music fan, I mean, it just felt good to be there. Funny story. So, I did not get this on camera because I'm not a creep. But there was some people having a good time near us, and they these girls, like, one of them was wearing like coochie cutter shorts, you know, and the cowboy boots and all that shit, whatever. I can't remember the name of the song that come on, but when it hit, man, they just went, they were just up and at it. they ended up getting into the middle of the aisle. There was no reason. Where they were at was fine, and they could have had a good time there, but they felt implied because of this song that they had to get in the middle of the aisle, like right where people were walking up and down, and there was a ton of people, of course, going up and down, and they're just dancing away freely. And it was funny too, because there was like some dudes, or like I remember this one dude's trying to get through, and it was just kind of like, you know, to avoid them. But it was funny. But the best part was, so that started, and then from a row back, this tiny, I don't know, 20-something girl, 20-year-old something girl, just come down the blue and not wearing any damn shoes, and she's double-fisting, she's got double-fisting beer, and she's literally like, you know, like dancing, if you, I guess. But just going back and forth, you know, just like kind of just walking back and forth and grooving, you know, and stuff. And it was like time would go by, and then she would just randomly pop up again. Like, it was freaking hilarious. Savannah and I loved it. It was so damn funny. Oh, quick story. This guy right here. So, I actually went, believe it or not, I've seen Brooks and Dunn before. Many years ago, went and seen them with my good friend, of course, Dr. M. And when I went to go see them, I wore that exact same cowboy hat. So I may post some pictures at the end of it, or like post a picture or something, just so you can kind of see, like, and this was me when I was like a husky fat model, if you will, a few pounds lighter. Just say it. Look at this young, sexy beast. What a husky JCPenney looking model. Getting some silver bullets. And having some of that sweet nectar. To be young again. I don't know, man. There's just something about this crowd and stuff. It was just a good time. It's a good time. And that's not to say there wasn't good crowds at the other ones, you know. But it was, I don't know. There's just something about this one. So, but yeah. Great time. Up next, we've got Alanis Morissette with Garbage. That's going to conclude this chapter, or this episode, if you will. But yeah, next time we'll see you. It'll be Alanis Morissette and Garbage. So don't forget to like and subscribe, and look for us on all of our social media platforms. And until next time, I'll see you around.